A few days ago, my friend posted something on Facebook, and I don't have Facebook. I just happened to see a screenshot of what he posted, and it was something like, if a Jew does this, but a Muslim does it, they're labeled this and that. If a Christian wears this, but a Muslim woman does that, blah, blah, blah. And they, the last part of this post that he made was very anti-Israel. I will not repeat it or share this full message because YouTube will flag the video. Now, here's the thing, though. Everyone is entitled to their opinion, okay? I'm not about to tell y'all what to believe in this Israel thing or whatever, but my friends are not very happy with what he posted. And a few of my friends in this friend group of mine, not all of them, but a few of them, happen to be Jewish. It doesn't really help the situation that the friend who posted this anti-Israel thing is a Muslim. And if you know your history between Jews and Muslims, they don't have the greatest relationship. But they're friends here in my group. It doesn't look like it now. So for the past few days, I've been getting text messages and calls all about this. And they're thinking of cutting this guy off from the friend group. Now, I've also had a bit of uncomfortability with this guy before, because with all due respect, sometimes he's a bit of a vocal person. Everyone watching or listening to this has their own unique perspective on things, but there's a time and place, you know, when to share it, right? If you decide to ever do so. This guy, he's vocal no matter what the situation and time and place is. If he has an opinion, best believe you're gonna hear it. So he called me last night, right? The Muslim guy who posted the anti-Israel stuff. He called me and he's ranting to me about how everyone feels a type of way about his opinionated and vocal self. He's telling me, these guys don't understand. I'm not anti-Israel, but I am pro-Palestine. And then he explained his whole perspective on the whole Israeli-Palestinian conflict for the next 45 minutes on the phone. Literally 45 minutes of him explaining himself and his views about the situation. And I told him this, and feel free to disagree if you think my approach or my answer is wrong. I said to him, look, dude, you are a Muslim man who is very easily physically attributed as an Arabic. Okay, your name is very Arabic as well, all right? In America, you already have a tougher time being here because of how Americans look, stereotype, and treat Muslims in this country. Posting about Jews and Christians versus Muslims, people are gonna automatically assume, based on your background, your appearance, your name, and your open faith to Islam, that you have extreme ideologies. You just sat here and explained your views to me for 45 minutes, and now I understand that you don't have malicious intents. But bro, nobody is gonna know your true feelings or opinion when they just see you share a post that is anti-Israel. You can't just be out here posting your religious or political beliefs and assuming people know your true intentions or your full-blown beliefs at heart, especially considering you're a Muslim posting about Jews. I'm telling you the truth, but people are going to make assumptions about you. So that's why I told him. And he's trying to justify it still. And I get his perspective. I get what he's trying to say. He's like, well, Andre, people choose to go on my public Facebook or add me or follow me. And it's their choice that they decided to do that. So if they don't like what they see, just unfollow me, unfriend me, whatever. He's not wrong. But bro, don't be surprised when someone sees something, doesn't understand or know your true perspective or take on something, then proceeds to get mad. I'm telling him from experience. You know how many times I post videos about certain topics and people just assume certain things about my character or personality? I'm sure you've seen comments like this too. I'll talk about a certain subject or share something about my past or my life, and I'll read the most idiotic comments and assumptions about me. But it's the internet. I can't be surprised people don't do research. Duh. That's literally part of the internet. Stupid people read what others post online or just read headlines and make quick assumptions about everything. To avoid this issue, either don't post about sensitive topics, right? Like the Middle East conflict, or don't be surprised when people feel this way. If you plan to post stuff. Religion is a very interesting thing because if you're familiar with me, I've been studying theology and overall religion in general for maybe the past 10 years now. Although there are some positive aspects in religion, unfortunately, religion has been a source of conflict and division for communities that aren't in favor of their belief system. Wars, discrimination, persecution have been rooted by religious differences. Religion can inspire people to do good, but when you take religion and some of the scriptures too literally or try to force it down someone else's throat, people are going to not be happy about it. Religion has historically been a source of suppression towards scientific advancement, women's rights, and other communities. Now, you may assume I'm going on an atheist rant, and this is exactly what I meant to my friend here. I'm not even atheist, nor am I close to it. But just because I'm critiquing religion or a belief system associated with political ideologies, you might just assume that out of me. There are people who unfortunately think religion is completely all bad and there's literally nothing good to come out of it. I don't really respect people who are like that, honestly. I feel like you're very quick to jump to opinions or you haven't really studied religion ever. In my opinion, religion can be good and bad. It really depends on how it's practiced and interpreted. This is what most people don't understand. Religion is supposed to be your personal relationship with God or gods, if you're polytheistic, right? It's not supposed to be about power. It's not supposed to be about control. It's not supposed to be about proselytizing others into your faith. If you believe in Jesus Christ, good for you. Mind your own business, bro. Good for you, okay? Just don't start trying to put Jesus Christ and his teachings in my face. You think people like that? You think people like ideologies being shoved in their face? And if you disagree or question it, you're labeled a devil worshiper or a sinner? This has nothing to do with what that religion is supposed to be about. I'm just using Jesus Christ as an example here. I'm not saying his teachings were bad, okay? I'm not saying anything, I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just making a point that dictating how others should live, otherwise you're labeling or demeaning them, is not it, bruh. P.S. Speaking of Jesus, Jesus did not live that way. So imagine forcing a prophet's ideas down someone's throat and you're not even following it yourself. You look stupid. If you believe in Allah, Jesus, Krishna, Hagate, or Osiris, or some deity out there, right? Whatever. It is your right to have that belief. But you know what? That should be celebrated in your own personal life. That does not mean go on Facebook or Twitter talking about wild things about other religions. People love being like, God is love. God is love. Okay. Then proceed to not spread love to others who also have their own rendition of God. If my version of God is different than your version, but we universally understand that God is supposed to be represented as all loving and forgiving and knowing, why even try to discriminate? Yes, I know in the Bible, God is not very nice, especially in the Old Testament, okay? So you might not even say God is love, all right? You might just say he's a creator or designer with an interesting personality. Why does it have to be he as well? I mean, you get my point. We could keep going down this rabbit hole. Remember how I said I'm not atheist? P.S. Even though I say I'm not atheist, I have no proof God exists. I can never prove it. Nobody can, okay? I do have faith, though, which is believing in something without scientific evidence. Everyone has faith in their own way. You know when you believe in yourself? I believe in myself. You can't really prove that physically, right? That's just you having faith in yourself to do whatever you plan to do. There's nothing wrong with having faith. There's nothing wrong with having something that you can't physically see guide you. So when people have faith, especially by usage of religion, they can find guidance or be inspired by certain quotes in their religious scripture. This is what I don't like. People will take everything in religious scriptures as a literal moral grounding. Yes, every religious scripture has a moral framework. Thou shalt not do this or that, right? But you have to keep in mind that these scriptures were written in a way different time. Some during war, some during times where extreme ideas is not acceptable today. And there are moral principles or laws found in religious scriptures that transcend time. Ideologies that still make sense to be used today, right? Even though people break them all the time. However, many of these texts were written to better shape societal norms and the challenges people were going through in the past. There are verses in the Bible that talk about slavery. The book of Leviticus got something, and unfortunately, some people in modern day believe human rights should still be taken away. They support slavery. It's a human rights violation. And even if you're a weirdo and believe slavery is still okay in some form or fashion, because I've seen that before, people on the internet, they believe slavery should be brought back or something like that. What you're failing to understand, because even if you have that weird belief, okay, it doesn't really rationally make sense. Owning another human being is not compatible with contemporary values of society. It won't work in modern day. Move on. Why? Some people are so obsessed with slavery and bringing it back, it doesn't even work unless society was completely reshaped. And that's not going to happen. In Deuteronomy, they talk about if a child is rebellious, give them capital punishment. I think it's chapter 21 in Deuteronomy. If I find it, I'll put it on the screen right now. It says something like, yo, if your son is rebellious and stubborn and disobeys you, go stone him to death. That's what it says. Dog, this ain't it. If your son is misbehaving, you just don't throw boulders at his head in the middle of the town square. But you notice a pattern here. Religious scriptures tend to have punishments for many things that we find to be an extreme way to deal with situations in modern day. This video can be 30 minutes long if I kept going on things in the Bible or other religious scriptures that aren't applicable or rational in modern times. This is why you should not take religious scriptures literally. If you are so, you got to be like 4 years old or somehow fit, like, You just never took a science class in your life. You may have never gone to school. If you believe an old man built a boat and somehow fit two of each animal, which somehow they magically didn't eat each other or somehow they obeyed the human, the ecosystem does not work that way. Nature does not work in a way where you're going to have issues with space, food, waste management, predators, and the diversity of animals spread across the globe. An old man did not do that. In Genesis, that doesn't even make sense to the ecology. Yo, in Genesis, it says Noah was 500 years old. I can assure you, a 500-year-old man cannot do that. People don't even live that long, especially back then. Stop coping, acting like these stories make sense. But even though it's clearly fiction, this is why religion can still be powerful. The whole story of Noah's Ark teaches metaphors and allegories about you got to understand the story of Noah's Ark, right? Where he built the ship and everything, right? It teaches stories and allegories of renewal, faith, and the consequences of moral corruption. Are these not problems today? You see what happens when there's moral corruption, right? You can see throughout history what happens. The world doesn't allegedly flood, okay, every single time. But you see allegorically how severe moral corruption can be and what it does to society, what it does to people, how it destroys, let's just say, the world, right? Again, symbolism for the flood. You can see how amazing restarting and renewal can be to your life, just like how the story, there's a renewal of society, of life, if you just take a break from everything. That's the lesson I learned from Noah's Ark. But I don't take it literally about the all that stuff. And my point is, you can take any story from biblical texts or religious texts and interpret it in an educational way. You can learn a lesson from it. If I ever have a child and I introduce them to religion, I'm going to be like, listen, this story or these stories where I'm reading to you, they're great and amazing, but look at the symbolic, spiritual, and the moral purposes of the story instead of trying to consider it as a scientifically accurate account. So this is why you have to approach religion with a critical mind and understand the historical and cultural context. You disconnect from reality when you focus on interpretations that are outdated and illogical. Even though faith is believing in something without scientific evidence, you still have to approach faith with reason and logic. This is why you don't go online talking about Jews and Muslims in Israel and Christian women wearing headpieces. And if Muslims do that, then, like, dude, what you're doing is mixing faith and critical thinking. However, even if, let's say hypothetically, it is a truthful thing, right? You can see that there's a weird paradox with society, with different religions. Okay. You're sharing about how Muslims and Jews are treated differently. Okay, you have to understand that this judgment you're making is more about imposing opinions rather than creating understanding. You're splitting people apart. One of the biggest problems with religion is division. It can gather people, but it can split people apart. My friend posting stuff like that is exactly the consequences of what he's doing. You're entitled to your opinion. But this is what happens with religion when it's discussed or when you're talking about it like that. Like even this video, I'm sure some people, I was just talking about the Bible a moment ago, how some stories don't make sense. So I know there's some people watching and listening to this. You're seething right now because you heavily disagree. I wouldn't be surprised. Some of y'all are mad. Okay. But hey, listen, I'm just looking at it from critical thinking, right? I'm just being honest with you. So, but now my friends are out here beefing with each other over this post, which he keeps justifying to put up, right? But he's thinking about his pride of posting it and weaponizing it rather than understanding the point that faith is a personal journey. I understand you're frustrated with the whole Middle East conflict, right? And you tell me on the phone you want peace in the Middle East and that you are pro-Palestine, but you support Israel at the same time, right? But look at what you did, bro. You created more conflict. Even if it wasn't intentional, he needs to understand how people get about these subjects. Anyway, what do you guys think? This episode is found on Spotify and YouTube, Times Square. Nightmare 7 a.m. in the morning though. No surprise, Times Square is you and I under those lights. No disguise, don't tell me everything you wanted was a lie. All those city lights, it's an endless night. Never expected you to bring me so much life. Close my eyes too long, then it's time to say goodbye. Let's dance all night until the stars don't show glow. Till the sunrise, then we go solo. Making up for all the times that we were low. Let's make some memories before we do go. Let's dance all night until the stars don't show glow. Till the sunrise, then we go solo. Making up for all the times that we were low. Let's make some memories before we do go. Caution, wait a moment, keep my heart locked away, it's filled with emotion. Gave the key to you, right in front of you is open. Hey, try your best to not leave it broken. Oh, it's been a while since you know it's frozen.